Good evening, students. Welcome back. Welcome to the Vedic Maths classes. I am your Vedic Maths teacher, Ms. Garima Singh. So, students, our today's topic is multiplication near the base method. Now, students, this topic you have studied before also. Yes, in this topic, you have studied the two parts. One was below the base method. And the second was above the base method. Now students, with these two topics, there is one more topic in this, which is mixed deviation method. Yes, you have studied below the base method. In this method, the numbers are below the base. If you have taken the base 100, the number will always be less than the base. In this method, above the base method, your numbers are above the base. If your base is 100, so your numbers are always more than 100. Now, in this topic, the mixed deviation topic, which is our today's topic. In this topic, you will get the sums mixed. Mixed means one number will be above the base and one number will be below the base. So, how you will multiply the sums in which there are mixed deviation? Mixed deviation means there are numbers which are above the base also and there are numbers which are below the base also. So, we will learn the trick how to multiply these type of sums. So, students, our today's topic is mixed deviation method. Students, those who have not seen my previous videos means below the base method and above the base method videos, please watch those videos first of all. Yes, please go through those videos, then watch this video. Otherwise, it will be very difficult for you to understand this method. So, our today's topic is mixed deviation method and it's a part of multiplication near the base method. Now, kids, let's start our trick with the first sum. I am taking a small sum first of all so that you can learn the trick in this small sum. Now kids, our first thing we always do is taking a base. Now you can see for the numbers which are above the base, how we take the base. See how many numbers? 2. So 2. And for this 9, see 1 digit, so 10. This way you can take the base, or you can also take the base like this. Like you always take the base a number which contains zeros. Like the base can be 10, the base can be 100, the base can be 1000, the base can be 10,000 and so on. So these numbers are closer to which? 10. So base is 10. So this way also you can take the base, kids. You can easily identify the base by seeing the number. It just needs practice. So first of all, draw one line in between. Students, is the same like the previous methods only, above the base and lower the base. But there is one slight difference. Please watch the video till last. So we have taken the base. Now as you all know that first of all, we used to write the number and then we used to write the base and we subtract them both. always subtract the base from the number. Means first of all the number should be there and then the base. This thing I have explained you in my previous videos also. 18 minus 10 is plus 8. So here right, you can put a line also and a dot line also, plus 8. Same way 9 minus 10. See here, number was greater, base was less. So answer is coming in plus. But here, number is less and base is more. So answer will come in minus. 10 minus 9 is 1. 9 minus 10 is minus 1. So right here minus 1. Now what you do students? You are well known. Multiply them both. Now, as you can see, 8 ones are 8. Multiply the signs also now. This is the difference which is there in this method, that you have to multiply the signs. In my last videos, in the below the base method and above the base method, the signs are always coming the same. If here is plus, then here is also plus. If here is minus, then here is also minus. But in this method, you will always get different signs. Means here is plus, so here is minus. Or you can get here minus or here plus. So whenever you will multiply them both, plus minus, so you will get a minus sign. Now, as you all do, cross. Our method is there, cross. So 18 minus 1 is 17. Now multiply the base with the number. What is the base? 10. See how you will multiply. 17 will come as it is and just put one zero here. Now the main thing, a different thing of this method. See 170 is there. Now minus 8 you have to do from this number. See here minus 8 is there. In my previous videos there is coming plus 8. So you are putting this 8 at the back. Now here it is coming minus 8. So you have to minus 8 from this number. Now 170 minus 8 is 162. And this is your answer. So students, I have written these rules so that we can do our second sum with these rules step by step. These are the rules which we have followed in our previous sum. So our second sum is 104 multiplied by 93. Now as you can see students, that we have the numbers above the base also and below the base also. So it's a mixed deviation method. Means you will get the numbers which are above the base also and below the base also. So the first thing which we have to do is we have to take a base. See, take a base. The first step. Now take a base. Now the base can be 110, the base can be 100, the base can be 1000. Now you can take a base 10, 100 or 1000. Now you can see that these numbers are closer to 100. So we are taking the base 100. Now put one line. Now your second step is subtract. Now how you will subtract? Number subtract base. Means you have to subtract the base from the number. Now 104 minus 100 is plus 4. 104 minus 100 is plus 4. As you know that this is more, this is less, so answer will be in plus. But 93 minus 100, see this is less, this is more, so answer will be in minus. And 100 minus 93 is 7. But there will be a negative sign because you are subtracting 93 and 100. Means you are subtracting 100 from 93. So you will get minus 7. Now multiply them both. 7 4s are 28 and plus minus minus. Now you can see, students, that in the previous sum also you are getting minus. Here also you are getting minus. And in my next sum also you will get minus, because these sums are mixed deviation. One number will always be above the base and one number will always be below the base. So you will always get one positive and one negative. So keep it in your mind that here will always be minus. Now this you have done. Now your third step, multiplication. After multiplication, I have put one arrow. Arrow means that you have to multiply this. Whatever the subtraction part is there, you have to multiply it. Now the fourth step is cross. Either do this or either do this. I am doing this because it's easy. 93 plus 4 is 97. Done. Now what you have to do? See, multiply with base. The fifth step. Multiply with base means whatever here it is coming, you have to multiply it with base. Now your base is 100. So you have to multiply it with base. Now it's very easy. See, 97 as it is, and put two, these two zeros at the back. Now this, minus 28. Now two here, 9700 minus 28. See, 6, 9, 10. 10 minus 8, 2. 9 minus 2, 7, 6, 9. So answer is 9672. And this is your answer. 9672. So students, you can think that in case of applying this trick, we can apply the direct multiplication also. Listen kids, I will tell you where it is useful. See, I have done these small sums with this method. Why? So that you can understand this method with the small sums first of all. Then you can do lengthy sums. See students, this method is well applicable and it's very useful for the lengthy sums, where you have to multiply the long numbers, the big numbers, and there is no time. So you can use this method there. And it's very easy and it saves your time. But it needs practice. The first use. The second use is that you can check your answer with this method. Yes, if you are doing a sum in your exams and if you think that your answer is wrong, so you can check your answer with this method that your sum is right or wrong. And it's very easy. It will save time and you can check your answer very quickly. The second is, students, the trick will really help you in solving complicated problems in some seconds. It just needs practice. If you know this method, you can apply it in various places. In exams, for checking, for doing your sum, it will save time. So kids, next move to our last sum. It's a 3-digit sum. So now we will do a 4-digit sum. Now I think you remember the method and the rules I have written here, just scrap them. Now your last sum, which is 1, 4, 2, 3, 9, 8, 9. Now it's a lengthy sum. Now the first step is take a base. You can take a base 10, 100, 1000, 10,000. So you can see that your number is closer to 1000. Your both the numbers are closer to 1000. So we will take our base 1000. Or you can do like this also, that 1, 2, 3, 4 digits and 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 digits. So let's go for the second step. Second step is subtract. Now you have to subtract number and base. The 1, 4, 2, 3 minus 1000, it will give plus 4, 2, 3. And the second, 9, 8, 9 minus 1000. 9, 8, 9 minus 1000. So it will give a negative because your number is less and 1000 or the base is more, So it will give a negative sign. Now for subtraction, I have told you one trick. For these type of numbers, that last from 10 and others from 9. If you remember, students, 10 minus 9, 1. 9 minus 8, 1. And 9 minus 9, 0 means nothing. So your answer is 11. I can show you directly also here. Like 9, 9, 10. 10 minus 9, 1. 9 minus 8, 1. And 0 and 0. So, you can see here, 11 is there. Now, multiply. The third step is multiply, and in front of multiply, I have put one arrow, means you have to multiply whatever it is coming after subtraction. Now, for this multiplication, it's a 4, 2, 3, 11. We will put one 0 here and it will become 3 digits. I will use 3-digit multiplication method, IXI method, for this. In this 3-digit multiplication, what is the pattern? The pattern is I, X, triple X means 1, 2, 3, and after 3, back counting, it's 2 and 1. So, let's start. 3 ones are 3. Now, 2 multiplication, 2 ones are 2, 3 ones are 3. So 2 plus 3, 5. Now 3 digit, 4 ones are 4, 3 zeros are 0, 2 ones are 2. So 4 plus 2, 6. Now back counting, 2. 4 ones are 4, 2 zeros are 0. So it's 4. 4 plus 0, 4. And 1 digit, 4 zeros are 0. 0 means nothing. So your answer is 4, 6, 5, 3. See kids, how easily I have multiplied a number in some seconds with the cross multiplication method, or you can say IXI method of 3-digit multiplication. Now this you have done. Now the fourth step is cross. I am doing this type of cross. Now you can see 1, 4, 2, 3, minus 11 it is. So you have to subtract. Now 3 minus 1, 2. 2 minus 1, 1, and 1, 4 as it is. Now after this, what you have to do, you have to multiply with base. Now your base is 1000. So write 1, 4, 1, 2, and put 3 zeros at the back, minus 4, 6, 5, 3. Now subtract it. Now subtraction we will do orally, kids. 1, 9, 9, 10. Now 10 minus 3, 7. 9 minus 5, 4. 9 minus 6, 3. Now 1 minus 4. Now you can't subtract 4 from 1. So take one carry. Here will be 0 and here will be 11. Now 11 minus 4, it's 7. Now 0 as it is, 4 and 1. Try to do the sums orally, kids. This is the use of Vedic mathematics. It's make your calculation speedy, accurate, and it makes your calculation strong also. So I hope, students, you get my today's video. With this topic, our multiplication near the base method is completed. Yes, this topic contains three parts: above the base, below the base, and mixed variation. This is the last video of this topic and we have completed this topic now. Students, in my next video, we will meet with a new topic, new concept and trick. So kids, with this video, I have given you one practice PDF related to these sums. Do that practice PDF in your Vedic Maths notebook and please complete your Vedic Maths work, all the pending Vedic Maths work in your notebooks. And students, with this video, one message is there. In that message, my number is there. If you will face any problem regarding any trick, concept, work or any PDF, you can call or message me in that number. So kids, make sure you watch every single video and stay tuned to my video to learn more concepts and tricks. So next time, we will meet with a new topic. Thank you.